Hello, everyone. Murray here, coming at you from the Sci Fi Convention here in Second Life. As we cover the convention further, we have the wonderful United Federation Starfleet Admiral, Miss Nora Durhadsen. Miss Nora, would you care to tell us about this group? The United Federation, I understand that it has some history behind it.
Right. United Federation Starfleet has its home in the Pinus Triplanetary System, way out in the Delta Quadrant. According to our calendar, the year is 2419, so we're many years after USS Voyager went through this region of space. We are, obviously, a far-flung colony of the Federation. But we have our own Starfleet Academy, and of course our own fleet of ships to explore this region of the galaxy, as well as to defend our corner of the Federation. Our ships run the gamut from small chance ships, like my own, to huge heavy cruisers like the Veracruz and others. We also have another colony in the Gamma Quadrant, Astraeus, which exists on a different open sim grid. We have been an active group in Second Life for, a lot of years, certainly longer than I've been in the group, which is I think 9 years come July.
Incredible. I do remember it being around in 2008, so there is indeed a lot of history.
Oh yes, the group was started in September 2007, I think, and we have been going continuously ever since. Today's UFS is an active community of Trek fans and role players. We have several active ships in Second Life alone. Most ships meet once a week, but we also meet up at random times in Pinus Tri, which is our central sim.
Interesting. Does each ship have its own specific mission?
I would say it is more accurate to say that each ship has its own story, within the larger story of UFS. For instance, the Maxwell, my ship, is a science and survey ship out in the Hack Cluster. We're doing the age-old Starfleet mission, exploration, finding new worlds and new civilizations. But other ships might have a different bent. We've had ships that are dedicated to defense, for instance.
Makes sense. Each ship is connected in its own way. I'm sure our viewers here would love to hear just how one might get an assignment onto one of these vessels.
That part's easy, with the uniforms off or on. Each ship is a group of friends and storytellers, and the fleet is our larger circle of friends. So first one joins UFS, after Academy, one guests on a ship to find out what it's all about, and then the ship might invite the new person onto the crew.
Having an academy really does add to the immersion of the sim too, if I may add. If I recall, you guys have several classes to attend, from ship operations to actual roleplay classes. How long do these classes usually take up to?
How long academy takes depends entirely on the cadet. There is only one real required class, but one can participate in the midshipman program to get a larger look at what ships do. Even after graduation as an ensign, officers are welcome to take classes at the academy in a variety of Trek-related subjects, and can even earn virtual certificates in various fields. It can be as little as a day, or as long as, I suppose years. Oh, I almost forgot, as far as immersion goes, UFS is going to start up a program where Academy meets for in-world classes for a 4-week term. Participants can be either professors or cadets, regardless of usual rank, and get an Academy roleplay experience. I'd like to try it as a cadet. I do a great clueless cadet impression.
Well, that does sound like a great opportunity to get some ideas flowing too. Even I might stop by and check it out sometime.
You should. I think it's going to be a blast.
Absolutely. There's always more to learn, I'm sure. And over to our left is Miles, the deputy commander to UFS. Thanks for joining us. I understand that UFS also has a website up and running. Would you care to tell us about its features?
Sure. Thanks to our amazing CompOps team, we have a beautiful site that is a central location for all our information, from joining UFS, visiting our forums or wiki, and even a link to our Discord.
Very convenient. I'll be sure to put any and all links for our viewers at home in the description below, for everyone to check out. Well folks, it would seem that our time is running low, and we have a special part of the segment, where we will take a first-hand look at the Magellan. Admiral Nora, Commander Deputy Miles, thank you guys so much for having me. Stay tuned everyone as we check out UFS and the Magellan, right after this small pause.